Hello, I'm the Commander Xander. I remember it so that a stage critic doesn't have to. And neither should you. And welcome to Daniel Day-Lewis Month. Since it is his birthday month, I will be devoting the entire month of April to Daniel Day-Lewis movies. Because he is one of the greatest actors of all time. And we're going to start with a movie that he starred in the 90s called The Crucible. Based on that wonderful play that you probably read at some point when you went to school. It's all about the Salem witch trials because, well, there wasn't really much else going on in the colonial times besides Thanksgiving, Revolutionary War, pilgriming, all that stuff. So they decided to accuse people as witches, or Wiccans, I guess, if they were males. Will this solve anything? Probably not. Let's start Daniel Day-Lewis Month with The Crucible. And credit for the movie goes to 20th Century Fox. And no, this is not for monetary purposes. This is strictly for a review. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, we begin our story with a bunch of teenage girls doing teenage girl things in colonial time, which apparently involves rituals. What are they giggling about? Do they like me? The sacrifice must be made. So apparently they brought herbs, throw them into the fire, mention a boy's name, kiss the object, and throw it in because they want those random male people to fall in love with them. Do they seriously have nothing else to do in their spare time? And what do you bring, Winona Ryder? Who plays Abigail? Oh, good golly. Let me guess, is that the voodoo ritual needed object? While she stares in the background. Oh, great! A live rooster! Well, this ought to be fun. And guess who just happens to be strolling by and happens to witness this ritual? Why, none other than the priest, who just happens to be the uncle of Abigail. Not a bad connection. I'm sorry, I don't get Jamaican. What are you saying? What is this spell that you speak of? So apparently Tituba is not only a... Oh great, they're dancing. These are one crazy ass girls. Oh great, what does Abby want to do? She doesn't feel comfortable, so she's like, kill this sacrifice! Oh my god, she's crazy! Nice going! You've gotten the girls to go wackadoo! Now no boy's gonna want to go out with them! Good great, they're stripping! I know what he's thinking on the inside. Giggity, 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 giggity! Yep, run for your lives! You're gonna get crucified by the minister! Oh my god! Too late, he's already done it.
Say, only her eyes are closed.
It's the devil, isn't it?
This, of course, leads to the accusation of the devil. They must have landed 666 on that slot machine. Oh, wait, they wouldn't have that in medieval time. But, yeah, something is bound to happen. And that would be Diablo Pinier! Actually, no. Now that I'm thinking about it, the toast must have landed jelly side down that day. Jelly side down! Jelly side down! Jelly side down!
I agree with Reverend Paris.
Pray? What is praying gonna do? Praying's not gonna solve any fucking problems! Oh yeah, and for those who are wondering, the guy who played Edward Rooney is in this one. He was also in Beetlejuice. Sidetrack from all this is the fact that Abigail Williams has a crush on John Proctor, played by Daniel Day-Lewis. Who can blame Winona Ryder for having a crush on Daniel Day-Lewis? By golly, is he a chick magnet! After a sermon has been held, we have to call some random person and say, hello, we need you. That must have been an interesting connection. Hello, Devil Hotline, this is the person who knows what Diablo is. How may I help you? You're telling me there's a devil loose? I'll be right there. Click. Mr. Hale has to evaluate what the problem is. And can this be cured? I know the answer to that one. It's probably not. Oh, nothing out of the ordinary except a bunch of stripped down naked chicks who are crazy as hell because of some stupid spiritual ritual that makes them fall in love with the person they want to fall in love with. Gee, this would have been an interesting Romeo and Juliet plot twist, don't you think? After they confess that the devil is inside of them, we see that, ooh, a lovely doll was made. Not to mention there's a bunch of judges here that are going to execute any living soul that is accused of witchcraft. So Reverend Hale has to come in and have them confess the Ten Commandments. Now, you could mention those Ten Commandments, but seeing as how I've watched George Carlin, it's actually the Two Commandments. Thou shalt always be honest and supportive of thy nookie, and thou shalt try real hard not to kill anyone, unless, of course, that man prays from a different invisible man from the one you pray to. Two's all you need, people. Moses could fucking put them in his pocket. You don't need 10. Not even in the colonial days do you need 10 fucking commandments. Of course not. So after they get accused, we then have our Salem witch trials, which involves this little girl. Oh, shut up, mister. I think I'm so perfect because I'm the minister of this town. You're just as guilty as everybody else, you stupid idiot. Give him hell, Daniel Day-Lewis. Who clearly have been wrongfully accused, and this is all a big misunderstanding. French silk pie? They then bring the girls back in because, well, they're the whole key to the trials. How key are they?